They are master couturiers and are famous for their sophisticated global sensibilities, classic glamorous designs and flawless cuts. Known as the country's first prêt menswear designers, this dynamic duo recently completed 2 decades in the fashion industry. Joining us today on TaylorMade Biz in association with Linen Club are Rohit Gandhi and Rahul Khanna. So take me back to 97 when Rohit and Rahul, the brand, started. How did you guys meet?
I was working in a garment export company.
Okay.
And I set up an office with them all over the world, actually.
Yeah.
I trained a lot of students from NIFT who used to come and intern. And Rahul had come from Amritsar to Delhi.
Yeah.
I was studying with my apparel merchandising in NIFT.
Okay.
And in fact, we had common friends, so that's how I met Rohit.
Yeah.
And yeah, we were working together. I was interning with Richa Exports. Then I was designing for this brand called Bazaar.
Right.
Like it was, so we were just doing our thing. We met, but suddenly.
And I had no idea. I had no idea actually that we're going to be in a brand or open our own brand.
So between the both of you, because he was actually studying then, you were
yes.
able to bring best of both worlds.
Best
together.
Of both worlds.
Yeah, because I think how we merged together, because our similarities in taste, we were very minimalistic at that time. We wanted to do something very simple, which was not available in the market.
At the time, the world was full of bridal wear. Yeah.
All the designers were there, but
yeah.
there was nothing as a prêt brand. Mm. And we both were traveling to London together. We went for a holiday. We saw the sock shop, we saw the...
That was crazy, yeah.
So we thought, why don't we start with something like a shirt shop.
Right.
So we opened with a shirt shop.
Yeah.
And we opened it in my house, in the garage.
Yeah.
Thank God, no overheads. and it became a hit. It just became a hit.
Mm. First ever menswear prêt designers in India,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And it started with just shirts.
Yeah.
Different shirts. Mm.
So what we introduced was at that time was a fitted shirt, which was everything in the market was loose and baggy and everything. So people said, how are these designers going to make fitted shirts for men?
Yeah.
And who's going to wear it?
Yeah.
And a lot of brands, and big brands like Linen Club, they all specially manufactured amazing linens for us.
Yeah. Specially
Stencil
manufactured
linen.
For you
yes,
guys.
Yes,
we used to spend hours and hours at the linen factories, and we started with a lot of linen fitted club wear shirts, and they were new, and I think the trend was changing. Men were becoming fitter,
right.
They were conscious of their bodies, so it was an instant hit, and after that there was no looking back.
So do you use a lot of linen in your clothes, even
always.
Now?
We love linen.
Okay, good.
We love linen. Linen's always there, especially the weather in India, have you seen it?
Yeah, but people often associate linen with maybe work wear because it wrinkles easily, so they're a little scared about
it. Our client likes the wrinkle and he likes the feel of the, he's casual, he's fun, and he likes the feel of linen because the boys don't like the starch, crisp white shirts.
Mm.
It's there, but I think the linen has its own
You have
richness.
A market for it. Mm. You have a market for people who love linen.
Mm. So you have been associated with Linen Club from the beginning of your career.
Yes,
oh,
from
wow.
97. I think the first 5-6 collections are only linen, cotton blends.
Mm.
Yeah.
So yeah, we did a denim line. We are just working with Linen Club very closely because they have the infrastructure. They have some amazing machinery which nobody can copy. And of course, the collection is on the pipeline.
Okay.
It'll be our next 2000 summer collection.
Okay, that's amazing. So now you guys were doing menswear. How did the switch to women's wear happen?
People started coming up to us and started saying, do something for us in women's wear.
Yeah.
I think women wanted to wear the shirts.
Huh.
They all wanted the same shirts what men were wearing.
Yeah. So was that the birth of Q then?
Yes.
Right.
In fact, Kavita Bharatiya from Ogan gave us the first break and she said, why don't you align for Ogan, do office wear for women.
And when was this? How many years
this
ago?
This was 98.
There was nothing for women to wear. Nothing at all to wear to office.
The market was very, and there were no Zara's and
H&M's. There was nothing.
Okay. That really puts things in perspective.
It was all women were working, but they were all wearing Indo-Western
or
saris.
Yeah.
But I think we introduced the big flare pants with shirts and casual jacket.
And from there, we actually went on to discover more.
But you are the faces behind impeccable cuts, classic chic, glamour. I mean, you think red carpet, you know, you think Rohit and Rahul. So how did that evolution come about then, from menswear to workwear to now
this? Workwear to evening to daywear.
Yeah.
We did day wear for a long time. Then we started traveling and we started selling at different fairs. In fact, 10 designers were picked up by Trinoy, and that's one of the most important international fair
in Paris.
For fashion. And now we are the only ones. Maybe one or two more, but they dropped everyone. They have to actually choose you. So we are still there for the last 15 years now.
Do you think if you guys were to enter this industry now, it would be easier or more challenging?
I think it's very easy right now. Because the kind of hardships we faced, because there were no malls, there were no,
There was no market.
There was no market.
You had to create your own market.
All of us have actually created the market.
You have.
We've created awareness.
Yeah.
The awareness was the toughest to create. That people actually come up and they want to buy. Earlier, there was no concept of buying.
There was no fashion weeks that time. So, you know, remember the fashion week started in 2001.
Right.
So, you know, and it was, there was no exposure.
What are your tips to a budding fashion designer, fashion entrepreneur who's entering this very competitive world right now?
I think for them, it's the main thing what they should do is to make real clothes. And to not live in this bubble that if you have to make things out of, make things which are strange. You have to be realistic. You have to make very good quality. They have to focus on quality, on detailing, and they have to be sure of themselves, because and not copy other designers. Because copying is the biggest problem we face.
Well, I think
with young designers.
A young designer, they should find their own style, which takes a lot of time. It took us 3-4 years to find ourselves. We were doing everything. But I think sticking to your style, maintaining that style is very, very difficult.
And that's how you get noticed.
Yeah. That's great. Rohit and Rahul, thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much.
And I wish we meet again 20 years from now when you're celebrating 40 years in
the
industry.
I think we should be retired by then.
thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you all for watching. See you next time.